It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back, man. Welcome back. Feel good vibes all around in your Thursday morning. Always said it Friday. It does feel like
it
a Friday.
It does, yeah.
Don't worry. Tomorrow's Friday. It's all good. Now, we're talking baby talk this morning. Protecting your baby against diseases. It is a very common concern, I think, for parents with newborns especially. Mm-hmm. Now, wondering what role vaccinations play in this process and how many times you need to bring your baby in for vaccinations. So today on Baby Talk, trusted pediatrician Leana van Dyk helps us end the big debate on whether vaccines are safe or not. And there's a lot of conversation going around us.
Absolutely. First of all, I feel like they're more painful for the parent than they are for the baby when you have to watch your little baby being injected. I nearly cried the first time.
I will never. Leana, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Such a pleasure, man.
But talk to us about why vaccinations are so important in this day and age.
Okay, vaccinations was actually introduced many years ago. And since then, we've seen a massive drop in all these dangerous diseases.
Yeah.
We've seen pox being totally, we don't find any pox patients anymore. We see polio, measles, tetanus, diphtheria, all these diseases showed a massive decline. And in order to tell a patient or a parent why they need to vaccinate, I think you just need to explain to them how the vaccination actually works. Yeah. So we are exposed to bacteria and viruses on a daily basis. Our bodies respond to that and form antibodies. But the problem with that is that it takes a couple of days to weeks to form these antibodies.
Mm-hmm.
And by that time, you already had the disease.
Okay.
So what we do with vaccinations is we inject a small amount of inactivated virus or bacteria to the child or to the parent or to the patient.
Mm.
That then activates the immune system, forms the antibodies without the child getting sick.
Mm-hmm.
So when the child is exposed to the specific dangerous virus or bacteria, they have an immune system, and they can fight it immediately and not waiting for the consequences of these dangerous diseases, but they are ready to fight these diseases.
And then being a parent, and I know Kat will agree as well, we find it very, very important to go through these necessary steps. But I also do know that there are people out there that are very scared of going for things like vaccinations. They have their own thoughts around it, their own stigmas, maybe as their background, how they grew up, I don't know. But are there any other ways to protect your baby against all of these other diseases? I mean, you said pox, you said measles, there's polio. Mm. Any other way but besides vaccinations?
Look, if a child is in the womb of a mom, the antibodies are transferred passively to the baby. So for the first couple of months, a baby have antibodies from the mother.
Mm.
But those wear off. They're not there permanently, and the baby needs to build their own immune system.
Yeah.
Also, breastfeeding, very important. Breastfeeding has got antibodies. It's got other immunological properties. Very important for babies, things we can't ever create in formula milk.
Yeah.
If you look at hygiene, at nutrition, at hand washing, these are all important things. But in terms of building a child's immunity against these dreaded diseases, there is no other way to do it quicker, faster, safer. And all of these vaccines are evidence-based that it's proven to prevent these dreadful diseases of causing severe mortality in children. So they are natural immunological systems in place, but in terms of building your immunity in these children in their vulnerable years, this is the best way to go about it.
Because not small diseases we're talking about.
Absolutely.
I mean, chickenpox and measles and these things, they are serious, heavy, hard-hitting viruses.
Yeah, that nearly wiped out generations in certain parts of the world.
Absolutely.
Now, I never even thought of this as a question, but I guess it is to some people out there, and we do need to kind of destroy the myth. Are vaccines safe?
Yes. That's my short answer.
let's go first with, why do people believe that they are unsafe? Are there people out there spreading rumors that they're not? Or has there been cases where there was a negative effect from a vaccine that has made people believe that they're unsafe?
So a couple of years ago, in 1998, a doctor from the United Kingdom wrote an article stating that the MMR vaccine, that's your mumps, measles vaccine, causes autism. And he had a mechanism through the gut that it causes colitis and that might increase the risk of autism. And that had a massive impact on the world. Since then, the rates of vaccines has dropped, especially in the UK and the US, and the rate of measles infections and deaths due to measles has increased significantly.
Sure.
We recently had a massive outbreak in the UK again of measles because of this.
Mm.
Just to put it out there, that since then, this doctor has been scrapped from the role in the UK. And the MMR vaccine has been proven very safe by the American Diseases CDC and then by the UK CDC.
Yeah.
And it was actually found that this doctor accepted a bribe of over £55,000 to prove that the vaccine companies are fraudulent.
And I mean, that
So that has caused massive, massive damage. But just looking at the side effects of vaccines, very seldom. The common things are a little bit of tenderness over the injection site. You know, your newborn at the BCG, which is the TB vaccine, can cause a little bit of a scar or small abscess. Other vaccines, a little bit of redness. And then some vaccines can cause a mild low-grade fever with a mild rash that only lasts for a day or two. Baby is usually still fine. Playful, and that usually goes by.
No, definitely very, very interesting indeed. And funny you mentioned about the MMR, because I know that that filtered into South Africa as well.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And it was hard-hitting down here as well. A lot of moms were like, no, I'm not doing that. But anyway, so lots more to talk about. Thank you very much, Leana. Our Baby Talk segment will continue a little bit later on, talking about the importance of vaccines. It's my feel-good breakfast show.
It's my favorite time of the week, Baby Talk, when you hear that with my pimpana. Listen, I've got to say to my boy, I'm so proud of him. Two weeks ago, we did his latest immunizations, vaccinations, and he took two jabs. He went, and then as soon as they picked him up, he was like, oh, no, chill. He was so brave. I'm so proud of him. But we're talking about the importance of vaccinations and baby immunization. And we've got pediatrician Leana van Dyk here with us to answer questions. I think we've got a... Do we have a call right now? We've got a call, yes.
Do we have a call, yeah.
Serene from Cape Town, I believe. Good morning.
Hi, morning, guys. Morning, Leana.
Morning.
I just want to know, my daughter has got all exam and immunization. And she's 9 now, but they told me it's going to be for a 9-year-old child immunization. So I just want to know, is it still going to be on the card?
Okay, so she's turning 9.
She's 9.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes. Yes. So the 9-year-old vaccines are something that was introduced a couple of years ago, and that's your HPV, your human papilloma virus. Mm-hmm. And that is a virus that's number 1 cause for cervix cancer in women. So they've noticed that the sooner you vaccinate ladies against this, the lower the risk is later in life that they do get cervix cancer. And it's been introduced a few years ago already in the United States, and I've seen a decline in cervix cancer because of this vaccine.
Yeah.
So it's absolutely recommended to all parents to agree to this vaccination.
All right. Thank you very much for that question, Serene.
Yeah, we have another call on the line. Thank you very much, Serene. We have Kylie on the line right now. How's it, Kylie?
Hi, good morning. I'm very well. Thanks, yourself?
Good. Thank you very much. What's your question this morning for Leana?
My question is, my baby's 3 weeks, right? And she didn't get her BCG injection. So I actually wanted to know, how do I go about doing, what do I do? Mm-hmm. Where do I get it, seeing as though it's so important?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, so the BCG injection is against tuberculosis. Mm. So the important thing is, if you do get the BCG injection, that the child has not been exposed to tuberculosis in that period that he didn't get it.
Yes.
So if you're sure that your child has not been exposed to tuberculosis, or she's pretty healthy, then you can just go back to where you delivered. So go back to the clinic or the hospital, and they should be able to give you the BCG vaccine.
All right, Kylie, thank you very much for that. Cool. In fact, just as a general rule, right? If you have, because of scheduling or for whatever reason, skipped a vaccination, as long as your child has not been exposed to that particular virus or disease, you can still go back and get that vaccination.
It is just of the BCG that they were not allowed to be exposed. So all the other vaccines, if you have missed or you're a week or two late, just go back to your clinic sister or your healthcare professional, and they will arrange a schedule for you to just catch up on those vaccines.
Yes,
right.
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay. Thank you very
much. Another caller on the line.
Yes, Jamila from Cape Town.
Hi, good morning, guys.
Morning.
Good morning.
Hi, doctor. My question is, my baby is now almost 2 years, but when she had her measles injections, both at 6 months, and I'm not sure, I think 9 months or a year, both times she vomited. So I don't know if she's allergic to it. Do I still take her if there's like a top-up measles injection or what?
Okay, great question. Thank you.
Okay, if she had an injection at 6 months, and it was probably at 1 year that she had the second one, there's no need for another top-up. The thing you can consider is the MMR, which is your mumps, measles, rubella, a little bit later on. But there's no need for a top-up. And regarding the vomiting, It's not a known side effect of the measles. It's more maybe a rash and a low-grade fever. Mm-hmm. So it could have been coincidental, or it could have been because of the low-grade fever that she felt a little bit off and vomited.
As long as
it didn't persist for a long time and as long as she was well afterwards, there's no concerns about it. Yeah,
brilliant.
If you're allergic to a vaccine, it would be more a type of a rash and anaphylaxis, and that we found very rarely.
Okay, cool. Thank you very much for your question, Jemina.
Okay.
I just want to ask one question that I think is quite a topic of conversation for a lot of moms, especially seeing moms, you know, in my case, deal with the vaccinations. But what if your baby is sick, maybe on antibiotics, maybe have a cold, a flu, and you have that set date for vaccination? Can you still go get it? Or should you wait till your baby is good and off medicine or antibiotics?
Okay, there's very little contraindications for vaccines. So if your child has got a high-grade fever and is really sick on antibiotics, it's always better to wait just until they're a bit better, and then you go get it.
Yeah.
But a child that's running around, breaking down the room with a bit of a runny nose, low-grade fever, there's no reason for them not to get vaccinated.
Okay.
Children that's immune-suppressed, that's your children that's got cancer, leukemia, children that's on high doses of steroids, that's got liver or kidney diseases, there's certain vaccines they should not get.
Okay.
But obviously, the treating doctors and pediatricians will tell them what they are allowed to get and not.
Yeah.
Okay. So those parents must always just inquire from their doctors.
Okay. Well, if they're breaking down the house with a runny nose, they should be in bed because they're sick. We're taking a last call. I believe it's Nene on the phone. Good morning.
Morning. How are you?
Very well. Thank you very much for the call. What is your question? Oh.
Okay, I have a 10-week-year-old child. She went to the hospital yesterday for vaccination, and then her left thigh is swollen. What do I do?
Okay, so the left thigh is swollen.
Okay, so is that in the area where the child was injected?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, so like I mentioned earlier, that's one of the complications.
Mm.
It can be a little bit of redness and swelling over the area. So I would just keep an eye on it. If you think it's painful, you can give her a small amount of paracetamol or Panado or, you know, just to bring down the pain. But if she sees it becomes more red, more swollen, child is not well, it's better to take her back to the clinic that they just can check out that site where the injection was given.
Okay.
And I guess sometimes, most times, as a parent, you do assess the situation and your instinct tells you that this is something seriously wrong. Sorry, we have to ask this last question.
Yes.
This is all great, but what if I can't afford vaccinations?
Vaccinations should be free to everyone in South Africa. So if you go to a public government hospital or clinic, vaccinations is free. It is only the vaccinations in private setup, in our pharmacies, private pediatricians, where there is a small fee allocated to giving the vaccine.
Yeah.
But otherwise, everyone should be able to have access to free vaccinations in the government.
Vaccinate the nation. Thank you very much, Leana.
Pleasure.
Much appreciated.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much. That's your Baby Talk segment. It's on your Thursday morning for your
Dad Points.
Dad Points, bro.